Hi there, I'm Ben, and welcome to part 7 of my Let's Platinum Dark Souls series. The series where we get the platinum for this game. I'm going to walk you through every single step. First video is in the top corner now. You can check that out for a full rundown of what we're doing here. But yes, I'm walking you through everything. Right, at the end of the last video, we landed in Anor Londo, and that is exactly where we're picking up. I've just changed my pyromancy to my right hand. I said I'd do it in the previous video. I've now done it, and we're going to be using it a lot more because the Drake sword is pretty underpowered at this point, but we will be getting a new sword, Quaylag's Fury sword, near the end or two-thirds of the way through this video, and that thing is amazing. So yes, you can look forward to that. So I'm just kind of backtracking a little bit here. This is where we came into Anor Londo. You can see there's a chest in the back corner. I don't really want to fight these guys at this point, so you can actually dodge past them and just grab what's in this chest and then run back. They do kind of clip me on the way back and I do get lucky, but we've just hit a bonfire, so it's not too much of a problem if I were to die. Although I am in human form, so it is lucky they don't, I suppose. I just got some demon titanite there. We need that to upgrade boss weapons, basically the weapons we craft from boss souls, and Quaylag's Fury Sword is obviously a boss weapon, so we will be using that to upgrade. We're going to get it to about +4. We get quite a lot of demon titanite in this area, and we will get some more later on. The video after this is going to be the painted world, plus a bit of cleanup and maybe a bit of farming. And then the video after that's going to be a bit of cleanup again. So areas like in Sen's Fortress in the previous video, we didn't drop down and beat the demons. So we're going to be doing that and just getting doing a bit of a cleanup afterwards. So these two, there's two chests here, unfortunately. One of the chests is a mimic, so I'm going to have to kill it. So I need to get rid of these two. You can get their attention one at a time. It's definitely best to take these guys on one at a time. You can see how much damage pyromancy actually does to these guys. Great combustion is a really good one. And yep, oh, that was an unfortunate one. I think I still have fireball equipped. I didn't change to combustion, but I do like, although the great combustion and combustion are really short, you have to be really close to actually use them. They are really, really strong. Well, great combustion especially. So yeah, I'm using that from now on for quite a while, and I think I'll switch to, I think I do still have fireball at this point. That's the best move these guys can do, is the shield slam. It gives you a massive opening to attack. Yeah, I've still got the fireball there, so I'll be changing that in a moment. But yeah, that's not the last we'll be seeing of those guardians. There is Smough. So yeah, we will meet him later on. Here, you can see the chain is pointing towards me again. That means we're dealing with a mimic here. I don't know why I didn't cast that third one. I'm not quite sure what happened there. So yeah, we're going to be starting to use pyromancies a lot more now, as well as the Fury Sword later on. We're all fire-based, or I am at least. The good thing about pyromancies is, it doesn't use up your stamina, so it gives you plenty of left to dodge with. So there, that crystal halberd there is not particularly a special weapon. It's just a crystal version of a. There's some twinkling titanite. I'll explain about that in a minute as well. Is a crystal version of a weapon. We need to fully upgrade a crystal version weapon along with all other weapons. So raw, fire, chaos, etc. We need to fully upgrade each type of weapon. We got the lightning spear in the previous episode, and we're also going to get something called the Occult Club in this episode as well. These are all imbued weapons, so lightning, occult, and crystal. So they're partially upgraded at that point anyway, so we'll just be taking them five extra steps to upgrade those ones. I don't particularly use crystal. Or lightning's quite effective, but crystal, it does hit hard, but it actually breaks. You know, your weapon degrades Your weapons don't usually break, but crystal ones can break, I believe. And the only way to fix them is to level them up. So it just seems very awkward to me. So I'm not going to be using any crystal weapon. We'll fully upgrade one. Probably that one we picked up. Well, most certainly the one we just picked up. And then, we'll leave it at that, I think, for crystal. There's probably a use for them, but they're not for me. I hit too many walls, it'll probably just end up breaking. Right, gargoyle. The bell gargoyles before, very early on. Same thing here. You can cut this guy's tail off, which I do actually succeed in doing. There we go. To get the gargoyle tail axe. That is one of the rare weapons. If you missed it with the bell gargoyles, that is another chance to get it there. So hopefully you can do it here, or hopefully you got it in the previous area, to be honest. And there's also extra playthroughs. We're going to be doing another playthrough, so any rare weapons, I suppose it's a boss weapon, it was at one point, you will have another chance to get them. So there is a full list in the description. There will be a link to my website, and there's a full list of each of the rare weapons, miracles, pyromancies and sorceries that we need for trophies, so we can tick them off. I'm adding them as we go, so eventually it'll be the full list, but if it's not added at this point, if there's nothing in the description, it means we haven't got it yet. So you can kind of follow along while I'm uploading these, and then eventually it'll be all there. Here's some more demon titanite. Again, it's going to be very, very helpful. Yes, fury sword, can't wait. It makes this Drake sword seem just like, I don't know, like a cardboard tube or something. It's so good. And it actually works off humanity with it being a chaos weapon as well. So as long as we keep our humanity high, it's going to be doing a lot more damage. But again, I'll explain all about that once we get to it. So the only way into Anor Londo, or the main, I suppose we're actually in Anor Londo, the main church or cathedral, whatever it is actually up here. The lift is locked off until we've come up here. And then we have to deal with these enemies. I really don't like these ones. They're really weak, but they're also very dangerous, these guys. So one's going to drop down there. So you can always get the backstab on him, which is helpful, because there's going to be one coming around the corner for you. They use throwing knives a lot. You're going to see it in a minute. One hit from great combustion, is going to kill them with the pyromancy that we have. Or Pyromancer's Flame. Hopefully, well, you should have leveled it up to at least level 10. I think mine's sitting at about 11. We will be upgrading it later on to 15 and then ascending it to make it even better. So we've got to go across here. So I like to always have my shield in front of me. It just kind of helps me. It makes me feel more stable. Whether it actually makes me more stable, I have no idea. Plus, these guys are throwing these daggers. It's obviously not affecting me in the slightest. Not even the stamina's going down. You want them to run towards you, and they're going to hit you, and then you just hit them with the flame. I wouldn't go for a weapon. I don't like using a weapon up here. Although I've just got one out, is to cut this chandelier down. Make sure you cut that down. We'll be getting, you saw a little blue glow in it. We'll be getting that later on. Because we're going to go to a place called the Painted World of Ariamis, that sounds right. I'm not quite sure how to pronounce it. In the next episode, which is below us, so we'll be getting that then, because there's loads of those little these little white hooded guys. There's about 10 to 12 of them down there, and we don't want to have to kill all of those guys twice. So we'll leave it till later. So yeah, just let them throw their knives, and then when they run, take the hit. There we go, and then set them on fire. you don't want to be swinging a weapon around up here, because obviously it's very narrow, and it's going to hurt if you fall. So before I go through that fog, I'll just show you, there's a chest on this side, and the only way to get it is to come this way. It's not a very good thing in this chest, it's a divine blessing. I personally never use divine blessings. They give you full health and heal ailments, etc. I mean that they could be good in an emergency, But yeah, I either forget about them or I just don't use them. So yeah, if you want one, there's one here. And then basically it's the same thing to go back. There's going to be another one hidden around the corner as well. So there's the painted world, there's the painting, there's the chandelier. To get in the painted world, you basically just touch that painting. In the painted world, it is going to be our final farm spot as well. The best one. It kind of the best one. You get the most souls from it, but there's no easy way out of the painted world. You have to go to the end of it every time you want to leave. Like at the end of this video, we're going to get something called the Lordvessel, which allows us to warp between certain bonfires. You can't warp out of the painted world. You need to still go to the end of it. So yeah, farming, you need to sort of be dedicated to doing it once and then leave it at that. We will also need to probably farm a certain thing for the Blade of the Dark Moon Covenant. We need 10 Souvenir Reprisals. We will get one later and I'll explain about it then. So we switch this, we can now use the lift in and out of Anor Londo now. It's available to us. Here's another gargoyle. I've hit the lift again to go all the way down. There's another bonfire down here. So we're going to go and get that. It's not essential, this bonfire at this point. And he's going to hurt. That could have gone better. This guy does have an axe on his tail. I don't think I've been able to cut this one off. You may be able to cut this one off, but I mean, you've had two chances. You've probably got it by now anyway. Yeah, switch back to pyromancy. I've only got combustion left at this point, but it's still good enough. Yeah, it's definitely quicker. We're going to be leveling up. I've already got the gargoyle helm on, actually, so we get your shield as well. It's not one of the rare weapons, so don't worry about that. Yeah, I'm going to be leveling up dexterity along with faith, endurance, and vitality still. Dexterity is going to allow for quicker casting later on, so quick, great combustion and combustion is pretty damn good. Here's a ring and obviously a bonfire. The ring of the sun's firstborn boosts miracle strength by about 20%, I think it is. Okay, it's offensive miracles, so anything that deals damage. We're not using miracles yet. We will be using one or two later on. But yeah, I don't personally use them. I like to use fire. So yeah, I rested, did a bit of leveling there. Just might as well use the souls up because we're not going to need any at this point. And then we're going to be doing... Now, well, another reason is to unload those souls is we're doing one of the most annoying parts in the whole game, maybe. For some people, anyway. So there is the way into the painted world, to the lower part of where we were on the rafters before. But yeah, we'll do that in the next episode. Do that whole place. Yeah, so we're going to go try and go into the main cathedral. I think it is a cathedral. It looks like one. You'll be seeing these stairs a lot, especially if you play through all three of these games. We'll be back here. So there are two of those big giant guards, and then there's, you can see those gargoyle things, whatever they are. I'm not, what are they called? Annoying little, you know what I mean? Yeah, so you try to dodge past this first guy here, and then these guys just run past them. This one on the right can get you. There's nothing to find here, so just run, just go for it. There's two here, there's one on the left, one on the right. We need to go left, so we need to try. Unfortunately, that is close. The great archer gets me there. So, yeah, they've got great bows. So they do massive damage when they hit you, and they knock you back. Plus, the guys behind me are shooting lightning. So once you get here, this is maybe the hardest part done for me anyway. I hate trying to run past those guys and then get up here. So this guy here is the problem. We need to get up exactly where he is. Well, he's using a great bow. It pushes you back when it hits you. It's really narrow, and it hurts if you don't block it. So we're going to run up here. Do not lock on to this guy. Just leave it. The arrow, there's an archer to the left as well. Weirdly, he gets me. He's never gotten me before, but I don't know. It kind of hits my shield from behind. I don't know what's going on. But don't lock onto this guy. Soak the damage up, and then let him hit you, and then hit him with the pyromancy. Don't lock on and try if you... Hopefully you're not using a sword, or you're not reliant on a sword. If you have a pyromancy, it's not going to throw you forward as you attack. If you lock on and try and hit him with with a sword or whatever, you could follow him down. You could knock him over or off, but you'll also follow him down. So once you've got past him, you can breathe a sigh of relief. That's one of the most annoying parts. It probably didn't look that bad then, but yeah, you can quite easily get knocked back off that edge. So the main thing to do is not lock on. Here, I'm still in human form, so I'm taking this opportunity to kindle this bonfire. So every time I rest now at this specific bonfire, I will get 10 Estus. I recommend you do this. If you're not human now, don't worry about doing it now, but we're going to do it later on. Because we need to be in human form. We don't need to be in human form, but for Ornstein and Smile, the bosses of this place, we're going to be in human form, and we're going to get Solaire here to help us out. Even the numbers, so to speak. I know some people, the Dark Souls community, the fan base, the hardcore fans, are going to frown upon being helped by Solaire with Ornstein and Smile, but we're trying to get the platinum here. It's fine. We'll, yeah, let's make it as easy as possible, and he sure as hell makes it easier. Right, Silver Knights, get used to these guys. There are lots of them. They drop three weapons that we need, three rare weapons. It is quite a rare drop. I have been doing a practice run. I have two sort of runs I'm doing. I have a practice and then this recording run. On the practice run, I got two of the rare weapons, which is really annoying because I don't need them in that one at all. It doesn't matter to me. But in this one, I'm going to try and get all three of them so you can see them and obviously work together. Three sunlight medals, very good. We'll need those later on for leveling up a covenant. We only need 10, should have 5 by now. Yes, these Silver Knights, they have a sword, they have a shield, and they have that spear that the guy had in the previous room. We need one of each to be holding one of each for the trophy, so we need to get them. It is quite rare to get these drops, so what we're going to have to do at some point, it is up to you when you do it. I'm going to do it at the beginning of the next video, but if you want to do it now, basically you're going to farm these guys to try and get them. Any of them will drop the shield, because they all have shields, and then only a sword carrying one will drop a sword, and only the spear carrying one will drop a spear. You can help yourself by improving your item discovery. I'll explain about that in a moment once we've been down here. Once we see some more Silver Knights, I'll just go through that, but I just want to explain about this. There is a mimic here, this first chest, so if you stick to this wall and then this one here, you see the chain is facing forward. He's a mimic. He has the Occult Club, which is another imbued weapon. Occult is good, actually, against knights, both silver and black, and it's actually good against Ornstein and Smough. But do you know what's better against those guys? Is the Quaelag's Fury Sword. So that's what we'll be using. Also down here is something called the Dragon Tooth, which you may recognize. Havel's Great Shield, you may also recognize. And then also Havel's Helm, Armor, Gauntlets, and Leggings. Basically, you can become Havel. He's that big guy we fought in the bottom of the tower in Undead Burg. You can basically become him if you want. His armor, weapons, great shield, everything is ridiculously heavy. I do actually use it, believe it or not, but a lot later on. In the there's a boss called the Four Kings in this game, and in New Game Plus, they are pretty damn tough. So we want to just sit there and tank all of their... We don't actually need to move, which is fine because we can't, but we need to tank all their damage. So we're going to use Havel's stuff to do that, actually. Right, so yeah, you don't worry about Havel's. You're not going to be able to use it. It is all very, very heavy stuff. It does take a lot of damage, though. So they are good if you can, I suppose. But yeah, his weapon, the Dragon's Tooth, is literally a Dragon's Tooth as well, I believe, which is pretty cool. Yeah, I really struggle with these. I don't know why. I don't know what was going on. I have killed so many Silver Knights in this game, both in this practice, this one, and then my original Platinum playthrough those months, few months back. And I don't know why I was struggling with these guys. But yeah, fishing for backstabs is the easiest thing to easiest way to do that. You can see how weak the sword is that we have now. That's why we're not relying on it. Getting the backstabs on these ones with a spear is actually more difficult because they kind of spin. So their hitbox for it is in a different place. It's kind of in front of them as they spin. It's a weird one. It's definitely easier with the ones with a sword. Right, so we've got two chests we're going to do in a minute. They are both mimics. And they have coins in them, actually. So yeah, you can see down there, there's a demon. We're going to be dealing with him later. Titanite demon. Soul of a hero. That's good for 10,000 souls, I believe. So yeah, will be helpful. You may have noticed I've not been using... That's a shortcut we'll be opening later as well. You may have noticed I've not been using those sort of hard souls. I just use them for emergencies or when I'm just short or whenever. I don't really use them too often. So yeah, wake him up whichever way you like and then keep out of his way. The grab is the worst thing they can do. The kicks and the swipes are just blockable. That's the worst thing you can do. That's what he'll do to you if you just try and open the chest as well. It hurts, it kills you in one go. This one has the 5 silver coins. Silver coins you basically sell to somebody called Frampt. I think they're good for about 3,000 each. We're not going to be dealing with Frampt at all because we need to join a certain covenant, and speaking to him would mess that up. So we're going to ignore him, at least in this playthrough. So yeah, don't worry about that. So yeah, it's quite a lot of souls. We're actually going to get a gold one off this one, which is 5,000 souls. You can sell all sorts of stuff to this guy, but unfortunately we're not able to do that because we want to be able to join the covenant. So that one's locked. We'll deal with that in a minute. We're going to go through this shortcut, or open the shortcut up, should I say. You don't need to come and get this guy, just be aware that he is here, and if he sees you, he'll start firing arrows at you. You can see how much easier it is with the ones with a sword to get those backstabs. If they don't have their back towards a wall like that as they get up, then you can actually chain backstabs. With the sword, if you've got the same setup as me, it's 2 backstabs and 2 normal hits that will kill them. But yes, if you want to farm these guys at any point, now is not actually a bad idea, because they do give you a lot of souls. It's 1,000 each. So there's Onion Knight. We'll be speaking to him shortly. Or Siegmeier, should I say. Quick confession, you're going to notice I died. Yeah, I don't know what happened. I really was struggling with these guys. I shouldn't have. Like, look at that. I should not be struggling with these ones. I have no idea what I was doing. Anyway, yes, if you want to farm them, then you can either... I wouldn't really advise upping your humanity at this point, but you can put the gold covetous serpent ring on. That's going to improve your item discovery by 200, which is going to help with the chances of finding some rare weapons. Like I said, I'm not going to do it yet, but I will be doing it at the beginning of the next episode as we kind of clear up a bit and move on. Yeah, so it is good for souls. So if you are struggling with Ornstein and Smough or anything, or the NPC we've got to deal with, Lautrec, then and you feel like you want to level up, then just come up and do some of this. Try and get those rare weapons. You do need to get them. And don't sell them either. If you get any of the rare weapons, don't sell them. Don't do whatever. I don't know if you can give them away or anything. But Frampt can buy them, I think. So you shouldn't be speaking to him anyway. We haven't met him yet. So yes, do not sell any of the rare weapons. We need them all. Right, this is the shortcut we're going to be opening up. It's all going to make sense. It all looks very similar with those stairs. That we've kind of been up to come down. The two sets of stairs entwined. So it looks like we've just come up and down the same set, but we haven't. Here's another spear one. These are the worst ones. See there, he should be have his backstab there, but it's kind of at the front of him. It should be there as well, but it's not. There we go. I've got my two extra hits in. The Pyromancy Flame is really good against these guys as well. So if you know that you're going to be heading to a bonfire and you're able to spare them and you don't want to run out, you're not bothered about running out. So yes, I died again. Yes, yes, yes. Just the once. Just two deaths in this video. So I'll just show you where we are now. We're on the bottom floor again. Oh, it's not the bottom floor, but you know what I mean. Where we started. There's the bonfire with the Solaire. So this is where that first Silver Knight was stood, the one with the sword. And this is now your shortcut to the open bit. So we're just going to get rid of this guy now. Got my souls back. Unfortunately, now I'm not human, now that I've died. I do want to be in human form for later on, so we can summon Solaire. You can see in the top there, we're going to be getting the Silver Knight armor set. It's in these two chests. So yes, I cannot believe I got both the shield and the sword. I think it's actually the spear that seems to be the rarest. I remember it was the spear I didn't get last time until last. Annoyingly, when you are farming, you can still get the others. So you might need just the spear and keep getting the shield. Hopefully that doesn't happen. And you get all three pretty quickly. But yes, that is the thing that extends the length of the platinum for this game is the weapons, farming for certain weapons. Right, demon. We've fought them before, and we're in a really enclosed space here. I'm using Pyromancy against this guy for the simple fact that I need to dodge a lot. Lots of dodging, and Pyromancy obviously gives me that freedom to have all of my stamina. It doesn't do much damage because the guy's made of stone or titanite, for Christ's sake. So yeah, it's not doing too much. That stab to the floor is the worst thing he can do. Even if you're kind of not near him, it can still hurt you. You can come back and get this guy later on. Don't feel like you need to do this now. We can make him easier with the other sword we're getting. He is just a one-off. Once he's dead, he's dead. He gives you two Demon Titanite. If you want to cheese it, it takes a long time, but you can get him sort of stuck and just shoot him through the door like that. It will take you a long time, but it's a safe way to do it. He's going to swing at me now as I'm going through the door. He must have known I was coming in. That's a big slam. So yeah, just kind of stick to his left where his tail is and dodge. Is it a good thing to do? And just watch when he jumps in the air. Get away from him when he jumps, because he's going to do that. And that can kill you in one, and it can go right through your shield as well, so there's no point trying to block it. And then eventually you'll kill him. So yeah, if you don't want to do him now and want to make him easier, then just wait. And we will be running literally back past him anyway. So there's two Demon Titanite. I wanted to do it now because I'm going to be using that Titanite to level up the sword that we get. I'm just going to run back to the bonfire to get all of my Pyromancies back. Because we're going to go and invade Lautrec. You may remember that name, Lautrec. I know they all sound very, very similar. Lautrec, Laurentius and all that. We're actually going to invade his world. He's the guy that's killed the Firekeeper in Firelink Shrine. The guy with the golden armor on that was sat there, and he was... You could tell there was not something right about him. And yes, he killed the Firekeeper. Now we're going to avenge her death. And we actually get the Firekeeper soul back. So because I rested, unfortunately, these guys are back. You've got the sword guy and the two with the spear. I mean, I'm not too bothered because I'm looking for those weapons. So you can double, you can chain those backstabs if you get right behind him as he gets up. Unfortunately, no. yes, we're getting the Firekeeper's soul back once we beat Lautrec. This is a one. It looks like all the other Firekeeper souls. It's just a normal one in appearance, but it is actually the soul of the Firekeeper in Firelink Shrine. Anastasia, I think she's actually from the same place that Solaire is from, Astora. Anyway, bit of lore there, but don't quote me on it. Yes, so once we get it, so at the beginning of the next video we'll do this, but once we get it, we need to go back to her and bring her back to life. If you just take it to the other, to another Firekeeper, you can run past this one as well, by the way, to another Firekeeper like the one at the beginning of Anor Londo. Yes, you can level up your Estus Flask with it, but you will never be able to bring back Anastasia Firelink. So we need to, it's a one-off. It looks it looks exactly the same as all the others, but it is. So we'll be doing that once we've finished this at the beginning of the next video. Right. So we have the black eyed orb that we got from Anastasia's corpse from in Firelink. We pick that up. If you move a bit more forward in here, it'll come up sort of saying that it's vibrating to let you know you're kind of in the right place. Use it. And you'll invade Lautrec's world. He has two guys with him. This is what makes this actually fairly difficult. Lautrec's attacks cannot be blocked with a shield. They'll cut straight through. So get their attention and run up these stairs is the best thing I find. You want to get them in these kind of narrow sections here so they're not surrounding you. So you've got them sort of one or two facing you at a time. So you just need this guy at the front. The guy at the front here is Lautrec, the golden armor. You just need him. So get your pyromancy out. And don't overpress it, otherwise you'll do that. And yes, just concentrate on him. If he's at front like this, then go for him. There, we've got him. He's down. So as soon as he's down, get the hell out of there. Because you don't need to kill the other two. So it's just him. So try and keep him, keep them in this narrow area. You can just go in a circle around the place. You saw there that we got a Souvenir of Reprisal. We need 9 more of those. That was an ear, basically. And then we also got 5 humanity, which is pretty damn amazing. And the best ring in the game, in my opinion anyway. The Ring of Favor and Protection boosts HP, stamina, and load, but breaks when you remove it. So once you put it on, never take it off. It will break and you can't use it again. So leave it on. There's no reason to take it off. I mean, it's boosting your HP, stamina, and load. So what more do you want? You can see the extra boost on HP there where I'm not healed. That's how much it's improved. Just the HP. So the stamina is a similar thing. We've come back up the stairs now. We're going to go and help Siegmeier again. He's in trouble again. He's stuck behind a door where some silver knights are, so we're going to go and help him out. So yes, as well as the ring of favor and protection, we also, and the humanity, we also got the Firekeeper soul as well. So do not use that until I tell you to use it. Don't just go to the random one in Anor Londo and use it. You'll never be able to bring back Anastasia again. 2 quick backstabs on this guy. And then a double hit. But he gets away from me. And done. I'm saving my pyromancies because there's 3 of them in the room down here. You can deal with them one at a time, which is good. But here's Siegmeier again. He's a... struggling. He can't get through, basically. This happens a lot. But yes, just talk to him. And then we're going to go in this next room where the 3 silver knights are. There's one directly as you enter to the right, and then there's 2 ahead of you. The one on the right can get you. It's kind of hard to block him because he'll see you straight away. So yeah, speak to him until he's exhausted. The sort of what he's got to say, and then move on. So yeah, when he says the quick fix or whatever it is, fix indeed, then yeah, go for it. So yeah, you want to try and block. Yes, he's straight on you, and then he's got me stuck. I can't get off the door, so he's got me well stuck. Now I'm all a fluster, and it's not happening. But great combustion's great against these guys. Once they do a long attack like that, just hit them. I know I've been doing the backstabs. We will be using backstab later on. So it's just two of them on each one. Once we have the Fury Sword, it's one backstab and pretty much like one hit kills them. So yeah, just edge forward so you get just one of them on you. That move he just did then cannot be blocked. It will punch straight through your shield. So just be aware of that. There, two and done. And then, is this one? No, I thought I was going to go get a double one quickly there. And he's jumping out the way as well. This is why I don't rely on the pyromancies. It is great against them, but they can you can burn through them pretty quickly. pretty quickly, you'll run out. So getting used to backstabs is one of the best things, I would say. Right, go and speak to him again, and he's going to give you a ring. It's the Tiny Beings ring, I think it is. Tiny Beings? Yes, I've got it in the top. Why don't I just read that? Tiny Beings ring. Plus 5 HP, plus 5% to HP. Okay, we've got better rings on already, so just leave it. I've kept Havel's ring on for load, obviously. I want to be able to carry as much as possible. At the moment, anyway, once stamina is up, endurance is up, then I may take it off and replace it then. But it's still doing us a lot of work. I'm stood outside thinking, I'm sure I forgot something. Yes, I have. I've forgotten this chest here. I didn't miss it. Yes. Go and get it. It's one of the most important chests here. Two Demon Titanite. And that's it. We're done. You can now leave. Yeah, so I'm reading. I've got my notes here. I was reading my notes thinking I'm missing something. So that's what that was. Right. We're going to go back to the bottom floor to go back up through the shortcut. And then back into that main big room where we fought Lautrec. And go and get our sword. We are just going to go and get the Dragon Slayer Greatbow first, though. It's kind of on the way, so we might as well. So there's two big guards. You probably saw them before, maybe. There's one there, and then there's one behind. They're basically facing each other. We'll need to get rid of those before we can enter the boss fog for Ornstein and Smough. Smough, however you say it, is behind me. So we do need to kill those guys first, because we want to summon Solaire to help us. And if those guys are around, he'll just try and fight them. It's quite annoying, actually. So yeah, just be careful with that drop there. And get this Dragon Slayer Great Bow. That is what a rare weapon. So don't sell it. Keep hold of it. Don't need to use it if you don't want to. I think you need a lot of strength for that one. I've never particularly bothered with it myself. Got these little imps again. These guys are really annoying. You're going to see in a minute how annoying they are. They're quick and they dodge backwards, which is the problem. The guy ahead of us is not too much. I think you can actually shoot him with a bow or something and it knocks him back because he's that literally close to the edge. But yeah, when they come for you and attack, the window that you have to attack, they'll jump backwards again. Which you're going to see. As I go for an attack, he's back already. So you need to either get them to fall off an edge or pin them against something. I'm trying not to move forward because I don't want the other one to be coming as well. So yeah, I do the full circle on him. Yeah, no, he's just... Oh god, they're annoying. Nope, still not there. Still not there. Right. Done. I'm running out of pyromancies here. Yeah, I think you can hit this one with a bow and he'll just fall off. But we'll do a similar thing to what we just did now. Completely miss and force him off the edge. There we go. Titanite chunk. Good for leveling up weapons later on. We need plenty of those, so don't worry about that for now. But we've got it when we need it. There's the smith ahead of us. He's our saviour. So I did tell you to, at the end of the last episode, get a plus 10 curved sword. I used the falchion, however you say it. Hopefully you did that. If you didn't do that, I don't know why you wouldn't have done that. Yeah, the reason you had to do it, this guy can upgrade weapons, obviously he's a smith, but he can't turn a weapon, he can't ascend a weapon. So he even sells large titanite at a reduced rate as well, but it's cheaper. Also, buy this, the giant's halberd. So, yes, he can obviously upgrade weapons, but he can't make a weapon go into plus 6. So you can get it up to plus 5 with him, but you can't get it up to plus 6 to continue it, to ascend it, basically. So here we have the plus 10. You move to the right there. You can see Quaylag on the right-hand side, Quaylag's Fury Sword. You're going to use her soul. Plus 5,000 souls to make this weapon, but trust me, it is so worth it. We need it for the trophy anyway, so get it made. And then I'm going to forget to do the most important thing. I'm just excited about having this weapon now. So I'm going to equip it. I've not actually leveled it up. So the way this sword works is it scales off your humanity. So I'm at 4 now, I'm going to drop down to 3 and then go back up to 5. I'm actually going to use some humanity. It deals two different types of damage. You can see there in the, it says 66 and 187. That is melee damage, so I'm actually going to use some souls here, some of the hero souls. Make sure you don't use the core of Iron Golem. So I'm going to use both of these here, get myself 20,000 souls to level up. I'm not messing around farming souls, you can if you want. Just going to kill some more Silver Knights. But I want to get it done. So if you see this number now underneath the sword, where are we? So that first number, 66, which is going to go up to 72, is the melee damage. It's kind of the physical damage. And then we have 220, just moved up to 238. That's the fire damage, so it deals two types of damage. That will scale. Both of those scale with your humanity. So as your humanity goes up in the top left corner, up to 10, it will stop at 10. That's as high as it goes. Well, that's as high as the scaling goes. Both damage will go up. So I'm going to get it to plus 5. So that's going to give me... I'm going to go up to 5 humanity, which is going to give me plus 12 on the physical damage and plus 35 on fire damage. If you're at the whole full 10 humanity, it will take you up to plus 25 physical and plus 56 fire damage. So what this weapon allows us to do is not worry so much about dexterity and strength, whereas a lot of weapons will scale off those. I think this one might as well, but not as much. I will have to look into that. But what it allows us to do is, as long as our humanity is high, which we want to keep high anyway, for the sake of item discovery while we're going along, basically. See, I'm going to reverse hollowing here, so I'm going to go down. I'm basically going to become human. So it's going to go down to 3. I'm doing this so we can summon Solaire in a minute. And then I'm going to use 2 humanity. So I've got quite a lot there. I've got 31. I'm going to use 2 to bring me up to 5 to get that buff with the weapon to make it better, basically. I would make a save at that point now. If you're going to struggle, or you may potentially struggle with Ornstein and Smile, you don't want to be burning through your humanity trying to summon you can see how amazing this weapon is. Let's just admire that for a moment. A normal hit and a backstab, and it's down. Amazing. You don't want to be burning through your humanity. Every time you die, you're going to have to use another humanity to become human again. We need 30 of them to level up a covenant, so do not go using it. You'll want to make a save, a backup save. You can die once or twice and use maybe one or two, but don't. Yeah, you don't want to be burning through them and running out. So just make a backup save. When you're all set up, that's probably the best time to do it. Yeah, these guys with the spears. There we go. So it even looks amazing, this weapon. It's supposed to be some sort of insect, I think. All the spikes coming off it, and then you got the fire. It's just so cool. Ornstein and Smaug, coincidentally, are actually weak to fire as well, so that's just a win-win in all aspects. So there is a great archer, there he is, and there's those two guys on the floor. Go round the top way here to get the archer first, and then you're going to be able to deal with these big guys on their own, one at a time. And yeah, and then summon Solaire. If you summon him before, he can get hurt quite a lot by the big giants. He can help as well, he does quite a lot of damage. But you want to keep him as high health as possible for the fight. If you're able to keep Solaire alive, you're going to get that that one humanity and the Sunlight Medal as well. Don't worry if you don't. Just you need him for the first part, basically. His main role in this fight, in this boss fight, is to separate the two bosses for you so you can bring down Smough. Whatever he's called, the fat one. That's not politically correct, sorry. The big guy. I don't think he's actually fat. I think I've read somewhere in lore it's just his suit of armor that's fat. He's actually quite got a muscular build underneath, so I don't know what that's all about with regards to the lore. But these guys now are a lot simpler with this sword. You want that shield smash, that's the best thing. They can do this, which they're going to do in a moment, and I'm not going to be able to kill him quick enough. He's going to use this yellow aura. That's him healing, so unfortunately I'm not quick enough, and I'm going to have to hurt him all over again. I'm saving my pyromancies for the boss fight, again, for the fact that it's going to keep my stamina up. If I'm using pyromancies, I have plenty of stamina to be able to dodge the hell out of there. If I'm just hitting, as good as this sword is, if I'm just hitting, I can't dodge out of the way of the other guy's attack. Here's the switch for the front door. So I'm just going to open that up. So yeah, Ornstein and Smough are weak to occult and fire. So we are pretty set up, really. And we're going to want to kill, I was explaining this before, we're going to want to kill Smough first. Because once you kill the first one, the other one that you didn't kill will become supersized and take the power of the other one. Watch out for this, that's a Wrath of God effect, so get the hell out of there when they do that. And depending which one you kill last is to which soul you get from them. You want... you need both of them, should I say, for a weapon. There's one for each of them, a rare weapon. So we do need to come and kill both of them again in a New Game Plus anyway. We're just going to do it in opposite. And basically, the harder one of the two is Ornstein. So you want to deal with Super Ornstein in New Game, in this game, as opposed to New Game Plus. He's going to be a lot more difficult, basically. That's all it boils down to. If you do it the other way around, just be prepared for a more difficult Ornstein fight. So yeah, once you've done that, come up here in human form, obviously, and summon Knight Solaire and make your way towards the boss fog. Another grand entrance, or another entrance that I do enjoy, is the Ornstein and Smile one. So I'm going to shut up for a moment and let this this intro play. Right, Ornstein and Smough. Ornstein's the little one. Smough's the big one. Ornstein, if you especially if you're if you've died and you're replaying, if you're coming back in, Ornstein will rush you at the start, so be ready to dodge out of the way. You're going to want to take on Smough, this guy. He's slow, he's kind of squishy with regards to health. You can hurt him very easily, so just do that. Just get him down as quickly as possible. You can see how quickly Ornstein's health has also gone down. He's at half already. So get Smough down as quickly as possible. You don't want Ornstein to go down first, because Solaire can do it. And then once he is down, which was pretty damn quick then, you're going to be moving on to Super Ornstein. He basically gets all of Smough's moves. Smough, he didn't do the move then, but Smough will do a butt slam. He will slam. Watch out for Ornstein's first move as well. Be aware of that. Right, keep your distance and just watch out for what he's doing. And keep your shield up because he has a really, really long reach as well. So when he's starting to attack Solaire, this move is one you want to watch out. When his spear glows like that, then be ready. It's a delayed there. Then that's when you need to dodge. It's kind of a delay. But he'll actually hit me with it in a moment. Here we go. So it's got quite good tracking as well. He got me just before the dodge there. Yeah, he picks you up basically and slams you down. I think he does all of the moves. So this is a dash. It's fairly simple. That is a double one. Here's the butt slam. So get the hell away when he does that. Does give you a nice opening to get some attacks in when he does it though. I'm using combustion here. I'm going to switch to the weapon, the sword in a minute, and just try and finish him off with it. Here we go. It does, yes, a lot more damage, but obviously it is using stamina up. But it's better than combustion. Great combustion is probably better. It's going to give you that stamina. He's done it to poor old Solaire there now. But yeah, just stick to him. And watch for those openings, and just when he's watch for the lightning attack, and that's pretty much Ornstein done. So you're going to get the Soul of Ornstein, and then I also get Humanity and Sunlight Medal. That's because Solaire is still alive, and then Ornstein will also drop something called the Leo Ring, which is really niche in its use. It increases thrust counter damage. I mean, we're not using a thrust. Oh, I'm not using a thrust weapon. And countering is kind of, as someone is attacking, you attack them. It's a niche use. It's probably a PvP or for more complex builds, I would think. But yeah, that was Ornstein and Smough. Yeah, just keep your distance and learn his moves, and you'll be fine with Ornstein. Smough goes down really quickly at the beginning. And now, because we've killed Lautrec earlier on, that we invaded him, this is his body here, or his armor at least. So you're going to get all of that. You don't need it for anything, but I thought it's a cool thing. We can also now purchase Ornstein's armor, his full suit. Do you remember Dom Nall in the bottom of the depths, where the Blight Town door is, where you use the key? There was a trader there. He sells armor sets. Once you kill certain bosses like Ornstein and Smough, you can go and buy them. You'll have to beat Smough last to get his, which is what we're doing in New Game Plus. So you can buy that then if you really want to. I mean, okay. They're just too big to even be... They're just comical, aren't they? I'm not sure what they were going for there. Anyway... this is Gwendolyn. She is the daughter. She will give you the Lordvessel. There, she said it. There we go. Lordvessel. We can now warp between bonfires. So you're going to get the Lordvessel trophy. I was not looking at something else then when I sort of paused. I was actually thinking what the word was. I wasn't distracted. I am now, though, not mentioned it. Anyway, yes, you can now join her covenant. So if you speak to her again, you're going to join the Princess's Guard Covenant. We need this for a trophy. You don't actually need to join it for the trophy, but you'll get a ring if you do join it. This boosts Miracle Synergy and slightly boosts the offense. It's the Ring of the Sun Princess, if I remember rightly. We'll get it in a second. We'll see. So we do need it to get the trophy there. So the Ring of the Sun Princess. There we go. I've joined it. Whatever. Got the ring. Probably not, never going to use it, but yes. So yeah, that is it. That's Anor Londo pretty much done. We can go wherever the hell we like now. We're able to warp only certain bonfires, but they're all in key places, so it's great. Yeah, so I'm going to end this video in a moment. I'm going to go out to the bonfire outside, and I'm actually going to level. Now it's up to you what you do. You can either level, you can either go back to Quailana and upgrade your pyromancy flame. Yeah, it's up to you. You can either wait, and I can give you some tips at the beginning of the next video once I've kind of made my mind up what you should do, what we're going to actually be doing. But yeah, leveling up is never a bad thing. We need to get up to 25 faith anyway. So with Quailag's sword now, we are pretty much set with regards to damage. So leveling up is kind of just there now. So I'm going to stick a load into faith and summon endurance. You can do the same if you want, or we can you can upgrade the pyromancy flame. We will be going to Firelink Shrine at the beginning of the next video anyway, so you can do it there as well. So yeah, save them if you want, and I'll tell you more at the beginning of the next video. But don't worry, if you do the leveling, it doesn't matter which choice you make. We're going to be farming for souls in the next video anyway, so you either or, they're both going to happen. So it's up to you. Right, thanks very much for watching. I'll see you on the next one.